Dear learners, welcome to the NIS studio. I'm Dr. Shweta, and today we would be talking about education and work, which is lesson number 26, module A of our psychology senior secondary course. So, as the name suggests, we would be talking about that what is education and how it is related to the work environment. But before we begin our discussion on today's topic, I want to take up a case study of Ashima, who did not know that what subject combinations she is taking and what are the consequences of taking those subject combinations. Let's begin with this case study. Ashima wanted to be a doctor. So, after class 10, she opted for the commerce stream for class 11. She was a bright student and passed class 12 with 85% marks. When she tried for medical entrance and obtained the forms, she discovered to her dismay that she is not qualified even to sit for the entrance examination for the medical course, despite her high percentage of marks. She was told that physics, chemistry, biology combination is a must for the medical stream. Well, Ashima is not the only such student to realize the mistake she made while choosing her subjects for class 11. This example makes us aware that there is a relationship between the school subject which we are taking and the profession or work to be taken up later on. How and what should be kept in mind while deciding about the subjects? So, with the help of this lesson, we would be analyzing the relationship between education and work or the profession one has to follow later on. You must have often come across statements like, education is necessary to get a job, or I want to work in this particular field, but I don't have the necessary qualification for it. Have you ever thought about how education and work are related? So, in this lesson, we are going to learn about the education and its relationship with work, as well as the important features of the world of work. Before we begin with our discussion, I just want to tell you that what are the objectives that are going to be taken up for this lesson. So, this lesson explains the relationship between education and work, as it is already mentioned. It also describes the process of educational choices. And lastly, it will describe about the nature of the world of work in terms of job profiles and job opportunities. So let us begin with today's topic. First of all, education and work, how they are related. We often come across advertisements for vacant jobs in which qualifications are expected from the candidates and they are given in terms of essential and desirable. Why do you think that it is expected that these qualifications a person must possess in order to get a job? Why do you think it is important? People actually go in for education not only for the sake of getting a job but also for enriching themselves. Education in any field primarily involves the development of certain skills and competences. For example, if you choose commerce, you develop skills for accounts. When the qualifications are advertised for a job, as I just mentioned, they are specified so that the person can use those skills which he or she has acquired over a period of time. The skills learned and the work to be done are interrelated. For example, if Ashima had taken up the medical stream in her class 11 and 12, she would have been able to sit for the medical entrance examination. Another example is that a person who has gone through the medical training becomes a medical practitioner. Learning of skills can take place both formally or informally. If you go in for a vocational course like poultry farming from NIOS, you can start your own poultry farm or get employment. So, your education of poultry farming will lead to your getting employed or having your own poultry farm. So that is why education and work are related. The process of educational choice. So now we know that taking up the subjects wisely is very important because what subjects we have taken in class 11 and 12 will lead to the profession of our choice. So, let us know more about the process of educational choice. When you go to the market, what happens? You see a wide variety of things available. But neither happens nor it is possible that you pick everything which is around you. Even when you go to the vegetable market, you only choose those vegetables which you would like to have or which you can afford. Doing so is a process. You can find the vegetables of your choice and then about its price. In the same way, choosing education is also a process. You just don't go and get yourself admitted in any school or choose the subjects without thinking. In fact, entry into the educational system itself starts with the process of choice making. Basically, when one starts the choice, it is from a general pattern of education to specified training. Let us study in some detail about these two aspects. What is general education? General education aims at providing the students with elementary skills in reading, writing, knowledge of physical, social, and cultural environment, desirable attitude, values, and motivation. This education from a primary to degree level and above, the mainstream education is often considered as general education, except for professional, technical, or the vocational education. For example, the minimum general education that we think is required for entry into occupations or for the admission to various courses or special training is high school. That is, if you want to get for a vocational course or if you want to get a particular occupation, the minimum requirement which is there, that is that you should be at least a secondary past learner. Students undergo special training for entry into their chosen occupation. You would also like to know the institutions offering this required special training. Some of these institutions are special training institutions. For example, the professional institutions. What are these professional institutions? These institutions actually provide higher education. And the higher education, as we all know, is provided at the graduate and postgraduate level. And it prepares students for the specialized fields, for example, the medicine field, the law field, the technology field, etc. You become either an engineer, you do your MBBS, or you do your law LLB degree. So these are professional institutions. Then we have other special training institutions. Those institutions are called polytechnics. What are polytechnics? These institutions are actually offering those courses which prepare the students to become technicians and other similar professions like draftsmen, junior engineer, medical laboratory technicians, etc. Other than these professional institutions and the polytechnic institutions, we have some institutions in our country that provide education through distance education. Two such institutions are Indira Gandhi National Open University, that is IGNOU, which provides education at higher level. And then we have NIOS, which is National Institute of Open Schooling. And as you all know, you are studying this very lecture from the platform of National Institute of Open Schooling. And this is National Institute of Open Schooling Senior Secondary Course in Psychology. So you are learning this lecture through the distance mode. What is happening these days with the advance in technology, some of these institutions are also providing online courses, which is you must be well versed with the MOOCs that is available for the people. In these online courses, you can do the course sitting before the computers at home or in cyber cafe and you can study. This mode is becoming very popular these days and this is useful as well. Then we have some commercial institutions. These commercial institutions are like typing, shorthand, bookkeeping, etc. And these courses are actually offered by these institutions. We have craft training schools as well. And as the name suggests, in craft training schools, training is actually provided for simple craft. You can take, for example, tailoring, weaving, embroidery, etc. Other than these institutions, we have certain specialized institutes. What are these specialized institutions doing? These specialized institutions are linked very closely to the employment system. Film and Television Institute of India is one such institute. Then we have Training Institute for Merchant Navy and certain institutes of hotel management. These are some of the well-known institutes of specialized trainings that are directly linked to the employment system. Once we know that how education and work are related, we must know that what is there in the world of work. That is, how do we actually get a job? What are the different sectors in which we get the jobs? And what do we do? How do we get into those sectors? So, as the name suggests, the expression world of work itself explains its meaning. It comprises a very large number of occupations and industries. We call any person who is engaged in teaching a teacher. Do you know how big the teaching occupation is? It comprises teachers teaching at various levels of education, such as there are some teachers who are teaching the nursery students. They are known as nursery teachers. Then we have primary teachers. We have trained graduate teachers, which are known as TGTs. We have postgraduate teachers who are known as PGTs. Other than these teachers, we have lecturers, readers, professors, etc., who are teaching at the higher level. There are teachers for different subjects at school level or college level and university level. You also find that teachers for physically and mentally challenged people also. So, it is the case with all other occupations. As we just came to know that the teaching occupation is so wide. We have teachers starting from the very basic education, that is starting from nursery till the higher education, as well as we have teachers who are engaged in teaching the specially abled people. Looking into the wide range of occupations, the Government of India has brought out a publication, and this publication is known as the NCO, which is National Classification for Occupations. The National Classification for Occupation has divided the world of work into 9 major areas. I've mentioned all these 9 major areas over here. First is, we have the legislators, senior officials and managers. This is one area where people work. Then we have different professionals. If I talk about professionals, we can have, you can have engineers, doctors, etc. Then we have technicians and associate professionals. After technicians and associate professionals, some people are also working as clerks or are in the clerical jobs. Service workers and shop and market sales workers, skilled agricultural and fishery workers. We also have people who are working in the crafts and are related with trade workers. There are a lot of people who are working in plant and machine operators, and they are who are working in different plants and they are machine operators and as well as assemblers. We have elementary occupations as well. So NCO has divided the world of work into these 9 major areas. So as of now, we have learnt about the world of work. Once we know, we also must know about the job opportunities which are available. What are job opportunities? When moving to the world of work, we come across innumerable occupations and jobs. Some jobs are challenging and some are very fascinating. Like education, choosing a job is also a process. As we were just talking about that, it is very important that how do you choose your subject, and you must choose your subject very wisely, because your subjects are ultimately going to take you towards the profession of your choice. In the same manner, choosing a job is also very important. Each job has certain requirements which are related to the age, education and citizenship, etc. You might have seen some job applications. So whenever the job applications are published, there are certain requirements that the employer is wanting from the candidate who wish to apply for the said job. We have the age requirements, we have the gender requirements, we have the citizenship requirements, we have the physical requirements, we might have the personality requirements, we have the educational and training requirements, we have the experience requirements, legal requirements and licensing requirements. Why do you think these requirements are necessary? Let's take a few examples. For example, if I say that the job mentions about the age requirement, why do they mention about the age requirement? Because sometimes what happens that some jobs require young professionals to work for the said positions. Why? Because those positions might require more energy, more effort from the employee. For example, you want to sit for the civil services examination, which is taken up by the UPSC, which is Union Public Service Commission. Then you should be a citizen of India. Sometimes it is referred that there are certain physical requirements in terms of height and weight that is required from the particular candidates. Why height and weight is mentioned? Because certain jobs, for example, the armed forces have their requirements for the candidates who wish to get into the armed forces. So they need to fulfill the criteria for those physical requirements. We have seen lot of advertisements where the employer has talked about the personality requirements. For example, a person who wished to apply for this job must be very extrovert, which means that he must be open to people or he should not be shy. Why such requirements are there? Say for example, you are looking for the job of a salesman. So a salesman has to be active and interactive, has to be actively interacting with the people. If somebody lacks this quality, he or she would not be able to sell the products. So that is why somewhere personality requirements are mentioned. Then we have educational and training requirements. Why these educational and training requirements are given? Because what happens sometimes for some jobs, it is very important that you have gone through a particular course, because that course helps you to clarify the basics which are required in the job, or certain kinds of trainings are required, and those trainings you get only by doing certain courses. We have mentioned in the earlier slides when we were talking about the professional institutions or the polytechnics or other specialized training institutions that equip the students with certain necessary skills that are required for the particular jobs. So that is why educational and training requirements are given. Sometimes experience requirements are given, also given, that is if you wish to apply for a particular job, you must have this and this experience. 5 years, say for example, 5 years of experience of working with children, or 5 years of experience of working in an administrative environment like that. This is sometimes necessary to get promotions also. Then we have certain legal requirements or the licensing requirements. Why licensing requirement is necessary? For example, you wish to be a doctor, so you should have the license to be a doctor from the Medical Council of India. Or you wish to be a clinical psychologist, so you need to have the license from the Rehabilitation Council of India. So those licensing provides the information that you are capable enough for the particular job. So now we know that there are particular requirements when we are looking for the different jobs. So dear learners, this was actually about the today's program. But before we end up, I want to summarize what we have discussed in today's program. First, we talked about that education and work are interrelated. Why they are interrelated? Because there are specific skills that are required for carrying out the specific work. For example, you want to be a doctor, it is very important that your subject should be physics, chemistry and biology, because you acquire specific skills for becoming a doctor. Then we said that the process starts through the general level of education, the process of your education. It starts from the general level of education, which is up to the degree level, and then you move to the special training institutes. Then I also mentioned that there are certain special training that can be taken from professional bodies, polytechnics, commercial institutions, etc. We also discussed about the world of work, which comprises of a large number of occupations and industries. And as mentioned, there is a national classification of occupation, and this NCO has divided the world of work into 9 major categories. At the end, we could know that when we are looking for a job, it is very important that one has to meet the various requirements like age, gender, citizenship, physical requirement and personality requirement. Some other requirements like education and training and experience and legal and licensing requirements are also required for a particular job. So, dear learners, I hope that you could understand the topic well. With this, I end up for today's lesson. Thank you.